We finally have games launching this year, and E3 gets canceled. What up, viewers? What up? What up? Today is Friday, March 13th. Happy Friday the 13th. And that means it's time for a quick recap of the week in video game news. So, like I said in the cold open, yep, we've got games coming out. So, starting off this week, today, launching is Nioh 2, the hit sequel to Nioh from 2017, is a Ninja Gaiden-esque hack-and-slash fighter, kind of brawler game, and it's got an 86 Metacritic, so if you are into those, kind of games, I think it's one step away from like a Dark Souls-esque, but it's still much like a hack-and-slash brawler RPG. I think the last one was well-received as well. I didn't quite look into the Metacritic for that. But yeah, it's got an 86 Metacritic. The trailer kind of shows that how brutal the bosses are. I thought it was actually a really impressive trailer because it shows like every way the character kind of like dies. It's kind of fun. And then it even says like towards the end of the trailer that you will die or something like that. So it was kind of cool. I really liked that the game will be hard and harsh and frustrating, and for those who like that type of adrenaline rush challenge, I think that game might be right up your alley. But of the games launching this week, the one I'm more likely to pick up is Ori and the Will of the Wisps. So I don't remember when the last Ori game came out. I think it was about 4 years ago, but this one has a 90 Metacritic, and I know, you know, it might not seem like a big difference between 86 and 90, and it pretty much isn't, but anything in the 90s or above I typically think of as like games that you should play regardless of what type of game you play. Also, if you're an Xbox Game Pass subscriber, this is a first party title, so you know, if you have Xbox Game Pass or you want to pick up Xbox Game Pass and have it for a month really cheap, I assume there's Xbox Game Pass deals going on all the time. So you can pick that up very cheap and play Ori and the Will of the Wisps. I haven't played a good platformer in a while, and Ori's got a really cool art style that I didn't like the first time around, but now this game kind of like is coming out that at a time where like I feel like I need some kind of like chill platformer to play. So I definitely think both of these games will be enjoyable during the crazy times that we're in. Speaking of crazy times, E3 gets canceled. So last week we were talking about GDC and how they were canceled and a bunch of other, you know, within just a week, looks like everything has been canceled, and E3 is also on that list of things that have been canceled. We still don't know completely if the ESA, you know, there are plenty of other things that they can do during that time. The ESA might get everybody together to do a digital, you know, rundown. I think that would definitely make sense. Nintendo already does, like, Nintendo Treehouses during it, so they'll probably still be present doing that. But as far as, like, people on stages talking to fans, I don't think that will exist this year. Microsoft has already stated that they're going to go a digital path. Ubisoft is also doing the same thing, so I think there is an opportunity for the ESA to get people together and, you know, just have a continuous digital stream of E3 announcements, because games still need to be announced. We still don't know much about what's coming out in the second half of the year. We still don't know what next gen's gonna look like, so all of that is kind of pointing towards, you know, there's a lot of uncertainty right now. And people want to know what games are going to be playing. So I definitely think that there will still be a event talking about games that are coming up. Whether or not that means that, you know, everybody will be there, it just remains to be seen. But the I would assume the other publishers are still going to do something around that timeline. But who knows? Maybe they wait until they can do something at their own pace. But yeah, it's very interesting. It was kind of inevitable. I wonder if E3 is kind of, or the ESA is kind of wiping their brow, because people, I think, were falling out prior to the coronavirus concerns. So I bet they're a little bit wiping their brows that they can finally say we can cancel it because people were backing out. But some of those were due to coronavirus concerns, so that is also a consideration as well. Moving right along, Call of Duty Warzone launched this week. So much like Fortnite and much like the Fortnite model, it is both within the within another game. So you can play Call of Duty Warzone. There's just a way to interact with it via Call of Duty Modern Warfare, as well as there is a standalone free-to-play downloaded version of just Call of Duty Warzone if you want to play just the Battle Royale. I'm hearing very good things from a couple of my friends. I haven't downloaded it myself yet, but I'm looking forward to getting into that kind of Battle Royale. If I got into any Battle Royales and I played most of them, I've always thought like a tactical shooter was going to be more my speed, and so hopefully Warzone kind of scratches that itch as opposed to, you know, building that is Fortnite, you know, the Fortnite building or the character powers that is Apex Legends. PUBG's shooting just never felt tight enough, and so hopefully with a Call of Duty Battle Royale the shooting feels tight enough that I'll enjoy it for a long period of time. And then continuing on, there is a new Game of Thrones mobile game coming out. I believe it's coming out at the end of the month, which just kind of shows you how mobile games don't really like build up hype. They just kind of launch and then come out. I don't know. It's just a. I think of myself more as a console analyst, and so when I hear about these mobile games, and it's like I haven't even heard of this thing, but it's like popular. It's got 6 billion, you know, downloads or something like that. The fact that I haven't heard of it is like, what's going on? So just goes to show you that I know very little about how mobile works. But there is a Game of Thrones mobile game coming out. It looks like an RPG or tactical kind of strategy game taking place north of the wall. I think it's actually called Beyond the Wall or something like that. There's a Game of Thrones mobile game coming out, so I might actually download that and play that. You know, I've got a phone, Blizzard. Moving right along, GeForce Now has finally lost another publisher. 2K has pulled all their titles from GeForce Now. I'm starting to think, you know, after doing the little bit of in-depth research when I talked about it last week, the fact that they're like bundling all of this stuff together and then selling a subscription to their service with publishers' games that they may or may not have contracts with, it starts to feel a little bit more icky than I previously thought. Like, oh, they're just putting everything together and you can play it from GeForce Now. The fact that they're selling like a subscription service, you know, makes it feel a little bit different than I previously had thought. But Epic is all in supporting GeForce Now. So Tim Sweeney has come forward. He said that, you know, Epic is putting its full endorsement of GeForce Now, which at first I was like, great, you're going to put Fortnite on GeForce Now. People are already playing Fortnite everywhere else. So, you know, I didn't really think like they were adding to anything. But what I realized was if you can get all of your Epic Game Stores, all the games you bought on the Epic Game Store, and you can play those via GeForce Now, then that's a great way to bundle in all of your PC games all in one place, which is kind of what GeForce is selling. So, sounds like a good idea. You know, good on Epic for backing GeForce Now. Former president of Nintendo of America, Reggie Fils-Aimé, I'm probably never going to get that right, has joined GameStop. So he had stepped down like at the end of last year, maybe even more than a year ago. And so he stepped down from Nintendo of America. Doug Bowser took over. Reggie's like, I'm going into retirement. Now we get news this week that he is a consultant with the board of directors of GameStop, which, you know, he knows a lot about the industry. He's a pretty smart guy. You know, hopefully he can help GameStop with the woes that they're going through. But, you know, I assume GameStop already has a bunch of really smart people on their board of directors, but having one more never hurt. So, you know, good luck to Reggie and good luck to GameStop. Speaking of big people in the games industry, Bill Gates is stepping down from Microsoft, from their board of directors. He wants to saw the article. He wants to pursue more of his humanitarian endeavors. So that is what he wants to be focusing on. And you know, I don't. He's been around for so long that I can see that he's probably not helping with the day to day every day. So yeah, good on him. I don't know if this quite counts as a retirement or if he's completely done with Microsoft, but you know, he's made his money, and now I can see someone else taking the lead on that. There's a sale on Doom. You know, in just 1 week we'll be playing Doom or Animal Crossing, depending on, or both, depending on what you like. But if you want to play Doom very quickly, for very cheap on Steam, for less than, I believe it's less than $6, you can be playing Doom 2016. So pick it up, play it, get ready for Doom Eternal, because I am super hyped on it. I can't wait to play Doom Eternal. I'm taking Friday off next week. I'm going to be playing it all day. So feel free to stop by my Twitch stream and say hi and tell, you know, and hopefully get some gameplay that you might or might not have seen already. Yeah. Speaking of GameStop, they have a buy one, and Animal Crossing, they have a buy one or buy two get one free deal on Animal Crossing amiibos, so you can start building up your amiibo collection before you play Animal Crossing New Horizons. God, Animal Crossing New Horizons this week or next week. So yeah, build up your collection of Animal Crossing amiibos. Go down to your local GameStop and pick them up. I don't know why I did that. Did that accent, but yep. Last but certainly not least, Control's first DLC, the hit game from Remedy Software at the end of last year. Control has its first full-blown story DLC coming out later this month on March 26th, called The Foundation. So I haven't played Control yet. I'm really looking forward to it. If you have, tell me what you think of it down below in the comments. Tell me what you think of the expansion or the next story DLC, because I'm definitely looking to get into Control sometime soon. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy this content. Thank you for everybody who's been commenting these last couple weeks. I really enjoy engaging with people in the comment section, so keep it going. I really enjoy it and I really appreciate it. If you like this, follow, like, and subscribe to me on YouTube and Twitch so you can see more great content like this. Links down in the description below. Thanks again. Stay safe. Wash your hands. Don't touch your face. All that kind of stuff. I hope everyone out there is being healthy and being reasonable in this crazy time. Hope you have a super day. I hope you have a super weekend. And I hope you have a super day. Bye.